Hello, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. I wanted to share some more Rated Updos, so if you have a favorite, comment down below. I love knowing which one you like the most. If you're new and you haven't subscribed yet, click that subscribe button, click that bell as well, then you'll be notified every time I post a new video. And let's get started. For this hairstyle, begin with your hair parted near the center. Divide out any hair that you would like to frame the face. And now create the first braid on the left side of the part. So pick up a section on the left side and divide it into three smaller sections. Cross the side strands over the middle strand and then begin incorporating new sections into the braid. Bring in two sections to both sides of the braid and then stop adding in hair to the back side of the braid. Continue crossing the side strands over the middle strand, alternating between crossing the right and left side strands over the middle strand. Incorporate new sections of hair from along the hairline, trailing the braid down the left side of the head. Create a lace style braid until it reaches the top of the left ear. Now stop adding in additional pieces and continue braiding the section in a regular three-strand braid. When the braid reaches near the ends of the section, slide a bobby pin over the bottom of the braid to use later on. Now repeat the same process on the opposite side of the head. So pick up a section on the right side and divide it into three smaller sections. Cross the side strands over the middle strand and then begin incorporating new sections into the braid. Bring in two sections to both sides of the braid. And then stop adding in hair to the back side of the braid. Continue crossing the side strands over the middle strand, alternating between crossing the right and left side strands over the middle strand until it reaches the top of the left ear. Now stop adding in additional pieces and continue braiding the section in a regular three-strand braid. Slide a bobby pin over the bottom of the braid to use later on. Once both braids are done, bring them around to the back of the head so they meet at the center back. Tie the two braids together. With the remaining hair left down, create a part line down the center of the back of the head and divide the remaining hair into two equal sections, a left side and a right side. Tie off the two sections using a clear elastic band. Take the right ponytail and bring it up to the braid, wrapping it around the braid so it crosses over towards the left side, and then back down on the left side of the head. Now take the left ponytail and bring it up towards the braid, cross it over the right ponytail section, and wrap it around the braid on the right side so the ends come back down on the right side. Now cross this end section on the right side across the top of the bun and tuck it under the braid on the left side. Use a clip to hold it in place while working with the other section next. Now take the ends from the left side and cross them over the top of the bun, then tuck them underneath the braid on the right side of the head. Take the two ends now and wrap them down the sides of the bun so they meet together at the nape of the neck underneath the base of the bun. Use a clear elastic band and tie the two ends together underneath the bun. Then roll or tuck the ends underneath the bun and pin it in place using a couple bobby pins so they stay hidden underneath the hairstyle. At this point, you can go back and gently pull on the sides of the braid if you'd like to make them look wider and more full. I kept mine mostly small and tight to keep the style a little more polished. For the next hairstyle, begin with your hair parted wherever you normally prefer, then combine all of the hair together into a low ponytail. Then use a hairband to tie off the ponytail near the lower back of the head. Now braid the ponytail into a three-strand braid. So divide the ponytail into three equal sections. Cross the side strands over the middle strand, alternating between the left and right side strands. Continue crossing the pieces over each other, working down the section of hair until it's braided down to the bottom near the ends. Tie off the bottom of the braid using an elastic band. And now take another hair tie or scrunchie and wrap this over the top hairband, only pulling the braid partway through to create a loop with the ends of the braid pointing downwards. Now pin the end of the braid at the top of the bun. So bring the braid up the side of the bun so it's wrapping across the top of the bun. And tuck the end of the braid underneath the scrunchie so it's hidden. Then use some bobby pins to pin the braid in place, sliding the bobby pins down towards the center of the style so they're hidden underneath the hair and won't stick out or show. This scrunchie is from my shop, Missy Sue Shop, and can be found through the link down below in the description box. For this hairstyle, begin by parting the hair wherever you normally prefer. Pull out any pieces that you'd like to leave out to frame your face as well. Next, combine all of the hair together into a ponytail. The ponytail should be lower on the head, near the occipital bone, but up off of the neck. Loosen the ponytail a little bit so you can fit two fingers into the ponytail above the hairband to create a gap between the hairband and your head. Twist all of the ponytail hair together, then push the hair into the gap and grip it with the forefinger and thumb. Pull the hair through the gap and out the opposite side so the ponytail is flipped under itself. Once the hair is pulled all the way through, take some hair padding and place this on the right side of the hairband. Use some bobby pins to pin down the hair padding so it'll stay in place on its own. Once the padding is pinned down, you're going to divide the ponytail hair into three sections and braid each section into a regular three-strand braid. With the first section of the ponytail, divide this into three smaller pieces for the braid. Cross the side strands over the middle strand, working down the section of hair. Take an elastic band and tie it over the bottom of the braid so it doesn't unravel. And then repeat this process twice more, creating two more braided sections with the hair from the ponytail. Divide the section into three smaller pieces. Cross the side strands over the middle strand, working down the section of hair until it's braided to the bottom. Take an elastic band and tie it over the bottom of the braid so it doesn't unravel. Once the braid is done, clip it up and out of the way to braid the third section of hair. Once all three sections are braided, use these braids to create the bun. So let down the clipped up braids and take the topmost braid first. Lay this across the hair padding and fold the end of the braid down. Take some bobby pins and pin the braid in place on the right side of the bun. Go over the braids and pull on the edges if you need them to be wider and fuller to help fill out the bun and cover up the hair padding. Take the second braid and lay this across the back of the head underneath the first braid. Fold the end of the braid if it's too long so the ends hang downwards. Then use some bobby pins to pin the braid in place along the right side of the bun. Now take the third braid and wrap this across the bun as well underneath the second braid and fold the end of the braid downwards again. Then use some bobby pins to pin the braid in place. Now take the ends of the braids that still need to be tucked and pinned, and you can either roll these or tuck these underneath the bun, but just use some bobby pins to pin them underneath the hairstyle, pushing the pins upwards towards the center of the bun so they're hidden underneath the hair and won't stick out or show.
That wraps up today's video. Comment down below if you have any suggestions for future videos. If you want to let me know which one was your favorite, I love knowing which one you like the most. Subscribe, click that notification bell so you never miss any future videos as well. Thank you so very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I will see you next time.